As it is for that those killings, so it is for electricity. I cannot generate electricity because it's on the exclusive list. Lagos has 40 million people. It cannot generate electricity. Imagine the day comes that California cannot generate electricity and have to wait for Maine to come and give them electricity. They will leave the union. Imagine the day that Texas is no longer in control of its oil fields. Would they remain in the union for 25 hours? And it's supposed to be a federation. What is a federation? So we have now, we are in a fraud now in which the federation that collapsed is being sustained by brigandage, and they have imposed a constitution that we can no longer question. And anybody who says, what are you doing? What was Abiola's offense? Do you know why Abiola was killed? The servant does not rule over his master. So it's not only Jonathan that had to be chased away because he wasn't one of those who could preside. These same people are doing the killings in the Middle Belt, doing the killings in the East, doing the killings in the West. They are the ones who seized everybody's assets. They are the ones who imposed this constitution. And you join them to go to elections under that constitution. By what constitution would they govern? Anybody who wins in this election, by what constitution is he going to govern? You are reinforcing your enslavement. And if they kill you in the process, it's your ignorance that killed you. We've been going all over the place trying to tell people that this is what is the case. They are not listening. We went to the men of God in the land, without exception, quietly. Sir, here's the problem. If Desmond Tutu did not join Mandela in South Africa, would you not still be in apartheid now? Where are all men of God? If not for people like this, who say, look, enough of this thing being said in quiet places. There's nothing I've said here that I've not said on national television. There's nothing I've said here that I've not said to the faces of those who have been governing Nigeria with this illicit decree. They are committing treason against the rest of us. They are committing treason against the rest of us because they put our signature on the document that seizes our assets, that seizes our lives. And we say, we have tolerated this document for 20 years, since 1999. We will not tolerate it any further. All of you, by the time they finish the election, less than 1,500 people will be sworn in as the ones who have won in the election. 180 million people are in danger. And they have managed to get you to come be on one side or the other. Put your mind the day after the election. The people who win will have to swear to defend and uphold your enslavement. The summary of what we are telling our people now is that processes have been undertaken. The majority, the whole of the South and the Middle Belt, have been told and shown what the problem is. That constitution must go down. Those who are going to contest under it are doing so for their intestines, not on your behalf, whatever they say. If you do not wake up and go to what will work for you, you are not only going to remain in your situation, they will come to where they turn up at your doorstep with their AK-47 on their mission to conquer. Let us leave it there.